My name's Alex Lawson. I'm the Executive Director of Social Security Works, along with our champions in the Congress and our allies around the country. We're here today to deliver 2.5 million petition signatures, calling on the White House to expand Social Security. We're really thankful that today President Obama is raising the issue of aging at the White House Conference on Aging, and we just want to make sure that our voices are heard. 2.5 million petition signatures, and I'm really proud to be able to introduce a man who needs no introduction, a man who's been fighting for justice his entire life, Congressman John Conyers from Detroit, Michigan.
Greetings. Greetings, everyone. Great to be here. Thanks for coming out. The weather doesn't stop us, does it? I'm proud to be here today, standing with all of you in these tremendous organizations and the more than 2.5 million Americans who've asked the White House to prioritize the expansion of Social Security benefits at this important conference on aging. Thank you to the AFL-CIO, to AFSCME, to Social Security Works, and the Alliance for Retired Americans, and so many others for organizing this important effort. Today, as we approach the 80th anniversary of Social Security, we're stating loud and clear, the American people will not tolerate any cuts to our hard-earned Social Security benefits. Yes. We will not. With companies continuing to cut back on traditional pension plans, two-thirds of retirees today depend on Social Security for most of their income. Social Security is our nation's most successful anti-poverty program. Without it, the poverty rate for older Americans would be over 44%. Thanks to Social Security, the elderly poverty rate is just 9%, but even 9% is too much for our seniors. So today I'm delivering the signatures of 72 members of Congress. 72 members of Congress, senators and members of the House who are echoing the call for this conference to make expanding Social Security benefits its number one retirement security recommendation. Thank you all for being here, and I look forward to continuing the fight to defend and ultimately expand Social Security. Yeah. Thank you very much. Yeah. Good to be with you. Hey, thanks.
Let me go right here. Because I get the another great pleasure of introducing Congresswoman Donna Edwards from Maryland, who has been a tireless champion of Social Security, one of the strongest voices for expanding Social Security. Please welcome Congresswoman Donna Edwards.
Thank you.
Yay, Donna.
Thank you. I don't know what I'm doing. Thank you so much, and it's really great to be here with my friend and my colleague, John Conyers, an amazing champion for working people. And you know what? A couple of years ago, we would have been standing here calling on the White House to protect Social Security from benefit cuts.
That's right.
But today, because of the hard work of organized labor, the hard work of Democracy for America, the hard work of the National Organization for Women, the hard work of all of our friends and allies across this country, we are standing here today joining with 2.5 million Americans who are saying, don't cut Social Security. It's time for us to expand the benefits and the protections and the retirement security of millions of Americans. And you know what I have to tell you, as an African-American woman, I know that more black women rely on Social Security because, you know what? Yeah. We don't have pensions. We don't have 401k plans. We have the protections of Social Security. And so I am delighted to join my colleagues and to join millions of Americans in saying it's time for us to expand the protections of Social Security, that we need to make sure that when you enter into the workforce and you begin to make those contributions over the course of your work life, that at the end of your work career, that you have the protection of Social Security into your retirement. This means retirement security for millions of Americans. And I don't care whether you call it expanding or enhancing. Yeah. It is time for us to strengthen the protections of Social Security. And with that, I am so delighted that, of course, you know, I'm from Maryland. And so we've got great Marylanders here too. My good friend Jocelyn Pena Melnick, my good friend Valerie Irvin, and of course, Jamie Raskin. And so it is a delight to be able to be here today to say, as Marylanders, we stand on behalf of millions of Americans who deserve retirement security. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yay. Senator Raskin.
Great. Thank you very much. I'm delighted to be here with Congressman Conyers and Congresswoman Edwards and all of our friends in organized labor, the National Organization for Women, and the Coalition to defend and expand and improve Social Security that includes millions of people from across the country. We're here to celebrate a great American success story, which is the Social Security program, which was created nearly 80 years ago with one principal conviction in mind, which is that old age should be a time of dignity, celebration, and transmission of values to other generations. It should not be a time of insecurity, despair, and distress. And Social Security has worked, and it's worked great for millions and millions of people in the country. And what we need to do now is to protect it, strengthen it, and expand it. And one way that we need to do that is by lifting the payroll tax cap, because 94% of Americans, it might be 95% of Americans, we pay Social Security taxes on all of our income, but it stops at $117,000 a year. And simply by lifting that cap, we will be able to fully fund Social Security for a 75-year period up to 80 or 90% of the gap that exists. So that's one very simple fix to making sure that we've got Social Security in all of the guises that we need it, for disability insurance, for life insurance, and for old age insurance. Social Security is America's primary insurance plan. It's time to declare our faith in it, our success in the program, and to expand it for future generations. Thank you very much.
All right, so next we have Delegate Jocelyn Pena Melnick.
Hi. Thank you. Just press it here.
Just press it.
Okay. Good afternoon. How are you? Oh, come on. How are you? I want to stand here very proud with Congresswoman Donna Edwards, Valerie Irvin. It's wonderful to work with you, and Jamie Raskin. I stand proudly, but I want to give you the perspective of a state legislator, just like your Congress representatives behind me, what kind of calls we get in my office. So about 3 weeks ago, I was talking to someone whose brother-in-law is getting Social Security, and basically it's just him and his wife. That is the only income he has because he did not have a private fund, okay? And so what happens? I started to talk to him. He's having a hard time. He can't pay his rent. It's not enough money, let alone health insurance. So I try to call the representative in Prince George's County to see what kind of other benefits and program, you know, might he qualify for. Guess what? None, okay? Because you're just at that line where you make like $5 more than you should. So I stand here to tell you, many people are relying on Social Security. That is their only hope. A lot of people do not have the benefit of having a retirement fund like some of us do. A lot of people, the wages have been frozen for middle class people. They have to worry about college expenses, making ends meet, and they simply cannot make it. This is not the time to discuss cutting it. This is the time to discuss expending it and keeping it, because it's simply the right thing to do, and because we made a promise. And when we made a promise, we should keep our word. Thank you so much.
All right, so next we have Valerie Irvin, chair of the Montgomery Council.
Thank you all very much. It's so exciting for me to be here among great members of Congress. Congressman Donna Edwards, Congresswoman Donna Edwards is from Maryland, as is Jocelyn Pena Melnick, and myself and Jamie Raskin. I know that it was told to me many years ago that retirement security was a three-legged stool. It was, one, your savings, two, your 401k, or if you're lucky enough to have a union pension, and three, it was Social Security. But guess what? As many of us in this audience know, many millions and millions of Americans don't have three legs on that stool. They have one leg on the stool, and that is Social Security. And especially for women, I'm a woman of a certain age that was never married, so I don't have a pension that my husband might leave for me. So I will be very lucky when I do end up retiring to have Social Security to take care of me as I age. And so I want to thank Congressman Conyers and the great Congresswoman Donna Edwards for inviting me to come today. But I know as we continue to fight on behalf of all those Americans who lost ground in the crash of 2008, it is going to take a very long time for people to catch up. And Social Security is what is going to save so many of us as we enter our retirement years. So thank you to the members of Congress who have been fearlessly fighting on behalf of millions of Americans just like you and me. Thank you so much.
So next up we have Julian Blair, ambassador from Spaces and CCA. Okay. Just hold this one.
Good afternoon. My name is Julian Blair, and I'm going to give you a first-person perspective on this. I'm a grassroots ambassador volunteer for Spaces and Center for Community Change here in the Washington, D.C., Maryland area. I live in Silver Spring, Maryland. Social Security and Medicare are important to me, and I would like to see these systems improved. I grew up poor on a farm right outside of Bowling Green, Virginia, south of here, along with my four brothers and sisters. My days were full with hard work and struggle, but from a young age, I was taught that honest labor would never hurt you. Right after graduation, I enlisted in the military during the peak of the Vietnam War, where I served for 23 years. After military, I worked for Corning Glassworks for 15 years, after which I worked at a nonprofit for 5. Today, I have a 94-year-old mother, whom, by the way, I consider the greatest American that ever lived, who worked and raised her 6 children, but whom only source of income today is Social Security from my stepfather. She raised her children to be productive members of society. Now, 2 of them, one of my brothers and my sister, both of whom worked for over 25 years, are disabled and drawing disability income. Social Security not only provides a source of income, but it allows us to live with some dignity in our golden age. However, in the last 10 years, we have seen that the cost of out-of-the-pocket medical expenses, transportation, housing, and many things that affect seniors have soared. But Social Security costs of living increases have not kept pace. The solution to this problem is quite simple. That is to expand Social Security benefits, which, by the way, is overwhelmingly supported by the public.
Yes, that's true.
So I'm urging President Obama to promote and support the expansion of Social Security during his brief at this White House Conference on Aging. Thank you.
All right, so next up we have Terry O'Neill from the National Organization for Women.
Thank you. Sorry, hey. Good afternoon, everybody. I am so thrilled to stand here with Congressman John Conyers and Congresswoman Donna Edwards and Valerie Irvin, a friend from years ago, and other and Jamie Raskin and
Jocelyn,
who's also from my home state of Maryland. All of these elected officials know something that we need to get through to the White House and the people who are meeting in the White House at the Conference on Aging, and that is this. Social Security is the solution to the retirement crisis that is facing our nation. I am really grateful to people like Representative Donna Edwards. She has been with us every step of the way, and Representative Conyers, stopping the proposed cuts to Social Security benefits. And now they are saying we need to expand the entire system. What do we need to do? We need to lift the cap on wages subject to the payroll tax. If you're making less than $118,000 a year, you're paying 6.2% in payroll taxes. But if you're making like $1 million a year, you're paying something like 0.6%. That's not fair. Millionaires have to pay their fair share, and we're going to insist that that happen. Number two, we need to have a caregiver credit. It is not fair. Women and increasingly men who have to drop out of the workforce or go part-time to take care of their children or to take care of family members, they get penalized at the end of their working life because their Social Security benefit is lower because they weren't earning wages during those years. Let me tell you, as a mom, they were working. Just because they weren't get paid doesn't mean it wasn't work. It needs to be honored with the caregiver credit. Number three, we need an across-the-board one-time increase in Social Security benefits because, as Julian said, that Social Security benefits, while essential to keep people out of poverty, is still not enough. It needs to go up, and our expenses are going up. Social Security needs to go up, too. And finally, we need a higher floor for the low-income earners who have worked a lifetime at outrageously low wages. Women are 70% of tipped workers in this country. And shamefully, the tipped minimum wage in the United States is $2.13 an hour. Your Social Security benefit on that is not nearly enough. We need to have a floor on that so that it gets higher and have more money for people who have worked so hard in these industries that don't pay enough. We've got a lot more things that need to be done, but today, right now, we are standing in front of the White House to say, expand the entire Social Security system. That is what the people of this country want and need, and we won't take anything less. Thank you all so much.
All right, so next up, we have Christian Dorsey from the Economic Policy Institute.
Okay, if I use my outside voice?
Yeah.
Okay.
Please.
All right. All right, I think I might be able to do without the bullhorn. Is this okay for everyone? I am pleased to be here this morning to share with everyone here this effort to expand Social Security. As has been said, retirement security is out of reach for far too many Americans. 401ks, IRAs, the much ballyhooed market-based solutions have failed to deliver their stated promise. They are far out of reach for too many Americans, and they are inadequate for those who have them. Now, I work at a think tank, America's labor think tank, and I'll say it would be awesome if we could come up with a policy solution for this problem. Wouldn't it be great if there could be a program that could reach everyone? Wouldn't it be great if there was a program that would be there even when the market got disrupted with catastrophic stock market crashes? Wouldn't it be great if there was a program that didn't eat up payments with exorbitant fees that go to money managers? Wouldn't it be awesome if that same program could deliver more help to people who needed it most? And wouldn't it be awesome if that program could be affordable within our budget context and enjoy broad support for the American public? Wouldn't all that stuff be awesome? Yes, it would be outstanding. Oh, wait a minute. I'm going to put myself out of a job. We don't need to come up with that solution because it already exists. Social Security, as Congressman Conyers wrote in his letter authored by 72 members of Congress, we have a program that is at once affordable. It is also universal. It is efficient, secure, portable, distributionally fair, and of course, wildly popular. Instead of thinking about cuts to Social Security, our efforts should be solely focused on how we expand and enhance it. We must remember, for all of the great things Social Security does, failing to deliver a caregiver credit is a key area of improvement. The wages across the board for Social Security recipients average $15,500 a year. That is not enough for many retirees to live on. We can enhance Social Security. We must enhance Social Security. That is mission number one. Thank you all for coming today.
All right, so next up we have Nick Burning of MoveOn.org.
I'll skip that too if it's okay.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm Nick Burning from MoveOn.org. I'm proud to be here representing millions of MoveOn members who are part of the movement to expand and enhance Social Security. And thank you for the leadership from all the elected officials here. We have changed the conversation. We're not talking about cuts anymore. We are talking about expanding benefits and raising the cap so the wealthiest earners pay their fair share of Social Security taxes. Two-thirds of our seniors rely on Social Security for more than half of their income. For one-third of our seniors, Social Security is 90% or more of their income. This is a bedrock program. It is crucial, and too many seniors with costs going up are struggling to get by. We have to expand benefits. We're making progress. This conversation is changing. Just this spring, 42 United States senators formally signed on to expanding benefits. The momentum is with us, and now we are here calling on President Obama to embrace Social Security expansion. In the past, when Social Security benefits needed to be expanded, other presidents have done it. President Truman expanded Social Security benefits. President Kennedy expanded Social Security benefits. Now we're calling on President Obama to do the same thing. So on behalf of millions of MoveOn members across the country who are part of this movement, we're proud of the work we've done. We're proud of where we're going. Now is the time to expand Social Security.
Next up, we have Neil Soroka of Democracy for America.
Great. Hey. Hi, I'm Neil Soroka. I'm the Communications Director for Democracy for America, and I'm not going to speak very long because we're just a few minutes away from delivering these petitions to the White House. But let me say this. 2 years ago, we were here standing up and trying to defeat cuts to Social Security that were in the president's budget. And now we have 2.5 million signatures of people saying, no. It's nothing about cuts. The cuts aren't an issue. The American people don't want cuts. We want to expand Social Security. And what you have here on the, behind me are a number of 2016 candidates running for office, running on this idea of expanding Social Security, because that's where the Democratic Party is, and that's where the American people are. So we're going to deliver these petitions right now into the White House to encourage President Obama to stand up and fight for expanding Social Security. But more than that, we're also sending a message to every candidate that wants to live in that house in a couple of years. Stand up strong for expanding Social Security, not just strengthening Social Security, not just enhancing Social Security. Be bold, stand up strong, and vote and support expanding Social Security now.
All right, with that, I'm going to call up Alex Lawson.
So I think Neil said it right, and we're going to, I think Congressman Conyers is going to take the petitions, which are in this binder, and we'll walk over to the gate, and we will deliver these petitions directly to the White House.
All right.
Let's go.
Got it. Yeah. Watch it.
Organizing, uniting,
educating,
motivating, all of those things. So.
So we'll actually just stop right around here at the fence. Yeah, they're not going to take them, so right around here. Yep.
They won't take them.
I mean, you can try, but generally they don't take them. Yeah.
Ring the doorbell.
Ma'am, step out the gate. Step out of the gate.
Thank you.
Now I know my limit.
Uh-huh. So if we turn around right here, we can...
All right.
Okay, here
they are.
And what I'll do is make sure that you can see the letter with all of the members of Congress.
Yes.
All right.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice drive.
And we'll take this and get it right into the White House with 2.5 million petition signatures on it. Thank you very much.
Before the next election,
there you go.